Afternoon, Red Bank. The countdown is on. We've got just over an hour until spring break. We'll be finding out how you'll be spending your time off.
Abusive relationships are more common than you might think. We'll examine the problem in our special report coming up next. It's one of the stories you'll see on today's edition of the Main News.
RBHS has a brand new college advisor. You'll meet the newest addition to the faculty coming up next.
Spring break is just a little over an hour away. We'll hear about the plans of students and staff. The story's just ahead.
The track meet had a great showing this week and a huge meet here in the Lion's Den. We'll have highlights plus a special preview of the 2016 squad. The video is coming up in sports.
And our resident funny man, Daniel Cox, has a brand new feature that you don't want to miss.
Hit me with your best shot.
It's called My School Musical, and you'll see it a little later in the show.
The boys' soccer team has been on fire to begin the season. We'll recap all the action coming up in sports.
And we have a possibility of some severe weather later this afternoon. The latest forecast is coming up a little later in the show.
It's Thursday, March 24th, and you're watching the Main News.
Family, you and me will always be tight. Family. Day and night, even when you start to acting like a fool, you know I'm loving every single thing you do. I know that I can always be myself, around you more than anybody else. And every day as a man after school, you know there's no one I love as much as you.
Family, a family, proud family. They'll make you scream, they make you want to sing. Family thing, a family.
It doesn't get talked about much, but abusive relationships are a real problem in our society. That's why our Wellness Center here on campus put out some flyers to bring attention to the problem. One out of every three teenagers in this country has been the victim of physical, sexual, emotional, or verbal abuse from a dating partner. We talked with some RBHS students that have been in abusive relationships. We've protected their identity by not showing their faces and disguising their voices.
My last boyfriend was real mean. He used to say mean things to me. He tried to hit me once and then I had to get out of there. That was just, I had to go.
Have you been in an abusive relationship? If so, how?
Yes, I've been cussed out a lot and told that, you know, I wasn't cared about. Love sports like that.
I think abusive relationships are horrible. Whether it's male-female or female-male, it doesn't matter. You should always be with someone that loves you with all their heart. And if somebody truly loves you, they're not going to be abusive to you. Always keep that in mind. I have no pity whatsoever for people that are going to abuse somebody they supposedly love. That's just my feelings on it.
If you or someone you know needs help in dealing with an abusive relationship, please stop by the Wellness Center near the guidance lobby.
RBHS has a new brand new college advisor. We started the year off with Mrs. A, but she had to leave on short notice. And although we hated to lose Mrs. A, we got a able replacement. Meet Miss Babel.
I have loved the students and the staff. The students are great. They've been really great, and especially the seniors this year, they've been awesome about getting their stuff done and very motivated, and I've just been really impressed with Red Bank High School.
I'm here with Mr. Kindergarten. How do you feel about Mrs. Babel being here so late in the year? Well, I wish we didn't have to make a change, but if we have to make a change and Miss Altfiller couldn't finish out the year, we have a fantastic replacement. Miss Babel is doing a great job, engages kids, brings a great different background, having worked in other countries, other parts of the United States, so a great asset.
Seniors, if you have yet to meet Miss Babel, she will be located in the guidance office Tuesday, Thursday, and Friday.
I'm going to go out on a limb and boldly predict that not much got done on campus today. That's because everyone has spring break on the brain. And whether you're going somewhere or just chilling at home, everyone is excited about a little time off.
Go ahead and start and make the kick part and whistle while you twerk. Yeah.
Hi, I'm here with Alana and Jalen, and we want to know what they like to do over spring break.
I'm going to sleep and I'm going to hang out with my boyfriend. Yeah. I'm going to get tan and go to the beach.
I'm not doing anything. This is my spring break plan, okay? I'm going to be working in the yard.
Hi, I'm here with Mr. Jackson, and we want to know what he wants to do for spring break.
Probably a little R&R, rest and relaxation, and playing a lot of golf.
I'm here with Sam, and we want to know, what are you going to do for spring break?
I'm going to Fort Bragg, North Carolina with the JROTC program.
Do you think it's going to be fun?
I bet it will.
I'm here with Elijah, and we want to know what you're going to do over spring break.
I plan on going to Florida to visit my uncle and spend time with him.
You're going to go to the beach?
Yes.
I'm here with Ms. Kate, and we are about to find out what she's doing for spring break.
I'm going to Disney World.
You gonna have fun?
Oh, yeah.
Well, I am potentially going out of town for the Easter weekend. Not for sure. And then the rest of the time, be working. Hopefully play golf at least once.
Adam here with Cheese, and we want to know what he gonna do for spring break.
Turn up a little bit, you know what I'm saying? Chill in the hot crib, you know what I'm saying? Go out of town a little bit, you know what I'm saying?
Know what I'm to be hard, booty shaking. I think they all dance at the Foxy Lady. I know some.
We won't be in school tomorrow. That's because it's Good Friday. It's the holiday that precedes one of the biggest Christian celebrations of the year. Many of our students and staff have already made their Easter plans.
It's super great, and my family—it's really important to my family. We all get together and eat, and the little kids have an Easter egg hunt, and it's just celebration of Jesus' life and that He died for us and that He rose again, and it's just super awesome.
And for Easter,
we're going to Disney World.
On Easter Sunday, we're going to go to church, and then after church, we're going to head to the beach.
I'm going to be in London, England on Easter, so I'm going to be celebrating Easter with style.
Well, the biggest track meet of the season happened on Tuesday here in the Lions Den.
And both the girls and the boys track teams have a nice showing. Let's get the highlights as we head over to sports.
I feel the master. I feel them. Y'all ready? They ready. Well, come on. Well, come on. Y'all ready? They ready. We ready. We ready. Come on. Come on. We ready. We ready. Come on. Break bread, ho. Break bread, ho. Come on. Break bread, ho. Break bread, ho. Come on. We ready. We ready. Come on. We ready. Come on. We ready. Hey, no questions about who the best. Facing on ladies. Hard to come to do the rest. Step in the way, multiple shots are going through the test. You must have gone.
The track team had a nice tune-up last week when they pronounced Signal Mountain in a dual meet. But this past Tuesday, 14 of the top teams in the region came to Red Bank for the first big meet of the season. Our cameras were there to catch the highlights. 14 different schools took advantage of the beautiful weather to take part in the meet. As we pick up the action, this is Sam Clark in hurdles event. She kicks on the burners and will take second place in this heat. Great job, Sam. The twins, known as Kendrick and Kedrick, battle against each other in the 100 dash. But Kedrick won first, and Kendrick came right behind, following in second. The Then the girls face off in the 100-meter dash. Alexis Foster got fourth with a time of 12.86. When the dust had settled, the boys' team took third place overall. They were just 20 points out of the top spot. The girls' team finished in fourth overall. Great job, Blue. Both teams have a goal of going deep into the postseason. Our Denny Ladreth previews the 2016 track meet.
How do you think the track team is going to do this season?
I mean, we should do pretty good this year. We got a few new people out there, so it's good.
Well, I think we might do good because our coach is coming back and everybody work hard.
How do you think you're going to do this season?
I think I'm going to do pretty well, actually. I know last season I had an injury, so I wasn't really doing what I wanted to, but this year, it's my senior year, my last year, I'm going to go out with a bang.
How do you think the track team's going to do this season?
I think we're going to do really good.
How's the track team looking this season?
We're looking pretty good. We need more people to come out, so you should come out, but we should be pretty strong.
And what events do you guys run?
I run a 100-meter, 200-meter, 4x1. Same thing he said.
I run the 400-meter dash and the 4x8 relay.
You think you're going to make a state?
Actually, yeah, I think I have a really good chance of making a state.
Okay, yeah. I think we have a chance of making a state if people work hard and do what they're told. Don't be coachable. What you got to say? I know I'm making a state for 100-meter dash, though. Like, and I know the 4x1 making it, too. So.
Oh, definitely. We have some promising people, like the twins and Alexis Foster. So.
We have Coach Stobert, Coach Turner, myself, and Coach Dunning. Looking forward to both boys and girls doing well this year. We have three huge track meets here with automatic time, and, of course, then the best of preps are Little Caesars as well. We hope to get several of our athletes to state, as always, and looking for a good year.
We'll meet you at the track meet.
There will be another big track meet at RBHS on Monday when we return from spring break. Mark your calendars for April 4th. The boys' soccer team has been on fire since day one of the season. Earlier this week, they pronounced Marion County by the score of 8-0. Sonny Boganovic had 3 goals, Tim M had 2 goals, and Alex Patel, Turner, Crow, and Braulio Vasquez all scored in the game. Then on Tuesday, they took a powerful squad from East Hamilton. Red Bank won the game 3-1. Sonny Boganovic led the attack once again, scoring all 3 goals. Red Bank is now 4-0 on the season. The guys have a huge district game on Monday. On the Monday we come back from spring break, they'll travel to Central for a game at 5. Sounds like a road trip. Stay hot, Big Blue. The baseball team won a doubleheader Monday over the Brainerd Panthers. The bats were on fire as they won 15-1, 20-1. The guys will play again tonight in a tournament at Central High School. Red Bank will take on a school from Illinois. Game time is 4. Good luck, guys. The softball team is also in the tournament this weekend. It's the Lookout Valley Invitational. The girls will play today versus Lookout Valley at 4. That game will be played at Silverdale. Come on out. And kudos to the JV softball team. They won the JV tournament this past weekend at Bradley North. Red Bank beat Saudi Daisy in the championship game. Great job, JV. The boys' tennis team got a huge win on Tuesday as they beat long rival Hickson. Austin Camp led the way, winning both singles and doubles. The final score was 6, Wildcats 3. The girls lost a close one, 7-2. The Netters will have a home meet on Tuesday. That we come back from break. That'll wrap it up for sports. Back to you.
Well, our resident funny man is at it again. Our Daniel Cox has come up with a brand new feature called My School Musical. But this won't be your typical musical. Check it out.
I'm hooked on a feeling. Hey man, watch where you're going.
You wanna go, bro? So you do wanna fight about it.
Why don't you hit me with your best shot? Hit me with your best shot.
The block is over! What have you been doing this whole time?
I've been waiting
for this computer to update.
About to change.
And the weather could get severe later this afternoon. Let's get the latest as we head over to weather.
Winter, spring, summer, or fall. Now all you got to do is call. And I'll be there, yeah, yeah, yeah. You've got a friend.
Oh, I didn't see you there. Well, the weather this week was very spring-like, with sunny skies and warm temperatures. But a cold front has made its way to the Tennessee Valley. Later this afternoon, there's a chance we could get thunderstorms and high winds. So be careful out there. Today, we're expected to reach a high of temperatures of 61 degrees. That's after a low last night of 46 degrees. There's a chance of spotty showers all day long. Both the best chance of severe weather would be around dinner time. But things will get better once the front passes, though, as we look at the five-day forecast. You'll see we're expecting sunny skies on Friday and Saturday. More clouds will come in on Sunday, and have a chance of rain comes back into the forecast on Monday. Enjoy your spring break. Back to the news desk.
Well, it's birthday time on the main news.
Let's find out who will be celebrating B-Day in the coming weeks.
You're feeling nothing's going right. Why don't you let me stop by? The clock is ticking, running out of time.
come out to the baseball or the softball game tonight.
Have a great spring break, Red Bank. Peace out.